Good morning and welcome back. This week's vlog is kind of gonna be a what we eat in a day slash clean with me. I kind of wanted to do like a what we eat in a day because I haven't done one of those, I feel like, either at all or in a very long time. So obviously you saw I made Avery a scrambled egg and some berries. He is chowing down as we speak. I always wake up with a coffee, as you guys know. So that is the start of our morning. He also has milk. So that is gonna be our video today. To recap from last week, I did not get anywhere on the nursery. That has taken a halt for the time being because we've had a bunch of other stuff we've had to do. So that is kind of just being put on the back burner for now. I will need to finish up measuring out spots and putting up stickers when I get the time to. We've also been planning a vacation soon, so that's gonna be taking up some time at some point. But obviously in no rush. I'm 23 weeks pregnant today, so I have time to get those up. Okay, while we're here, let's see if I can get the bump. I don't know why this lighting looks so dark right now. It's actually not dark. But this is the bump, 23 weeks pregnant. Baby girl has been crazy in there. And I feel like the beginning of my pregnancy, I thought I was smaller. And now that I'm getting towards the end of the second trimester, I really feel like things are ramping up and I feel very big. I just said the end of the second trimester. When does the second trimester end? I don't know, good question. Yep, so that's the bump. So one of my apps says that she is the size of a small squash. I don't really know what that means as like in squash terms. I have no idea. But the other one says that it's the size of a grapefruit. So if you can imagine a grapefruit, I almost bought one and I forgot. I went grocery shopping yesterday and now I'm realizing that I didn't buy one. She should be a little over a pound now and should be around a foot, maybe a little bit longer. So all of these apps tell me different stuff, so I really don't know, and I haven't been to my doctor in a couple weeks. My midwife. Oh, also, I don't know if I've mentioned this on this channel yet, but we have been calling this baby Squiggles ever since we found out I was pregnant. So that is her name for now. All right, so this says that the baby's about 11 inches, but I feel like it said that a couple weeks ago. So I guess I'm gonna go with between 11 and 12 inches long and about a pound, a little more maybe. That's what I'm gonna go with for this week. She is very active, especially at night. I have definitely had my struggles sleeping during this pregnancy, but my midwife had recommended Unisom sleep tabs and they have definitely been helping. I'm still tired and I still don't sleep the way that I want to most of the time, but it's better than nothing. I'm getting some sleep. I'm not awake all night, so that's cool. Some nights if I forget to take it, it's really bad and I just don't sleep. Aside from that, everything else has been going great as far as I know. I have a appointment next week, but that's like an online appointment, so there won't be much to tell from that. Sorry, I'm just trying to read this app to see what else I might be missing. Oh, I trimmed my hair. I'm sure it's not that noticeable, but I trimmed all the dead ends off because it was bothering me. Avery's favorite fruit is definitely blueberries. He has blueberries like every day and he eats every single one that I give him. He will not let one go to waste. That pile of strawberries and blueberries that you saw, the strawberries are sort of getting eaten and I'll eat whatever he doesn't eat probably, but he does not miss a blueberry. He loves blueberries. And I'm not mad about it because it's a good thing. Anyway, I think that's probably the gist of this. If I think of anything else, I will obviously add it in throughout the video, but we're gonna jump into what we eat and just a little bit of cleaning today. Okay, so for my own breakfast, I have been eating onion bagels for like the past 3 weeks. I'm on a weird kick with the onion bagels. I just do that with a little bit of cream cheese. A lot of times I'll share with Avery because for some reason he likes them also. But when I don't feel like sharing with Avery, I just hang out in the kitchen and eat it myself. So that's what I'm gonna do for myself right now, is just make myself a bagel. So the bagel is pretty much all I do for breakfast. Every day with breakfast, I have all my medicine that I had showed a few vlogs back. If I'm still hungry after this, I usually go for fruit, because obviously we have a bunch of strawberries and blueberries, bananas, apples, and stuff like that. So if I still get hungry, that's what I go for. Otherwise, I just wait till lunch. All right, so we just played outside for a good half an hour or so. It's pretty cold outside, so I convinced Avery to come inside for a snack. I gave him one of these beech nut fruit bars. He'll probably get a yogurt as well, because that's not usually enough for him. But I love these because they have only 5 ingredients in them. Some of them only have 3, but this one has whole grain oats, raisins, dates, sunflower oil, and dried strawberries. We also do like the banana flavor. There's like a banana pumpkin, I believe. And I think there's another one, apple spinach or something. He doesn't really like the apple spinach ones very much, so I don't buy them for him anymore. But I usually like to do a little bar for a snack and then like a yogurt or a fruit. He had a lot of fruit this morning, so that's probably the most that he will get until lunchtime. But that's what we're doing for snacks. So if he's still hungry after the bar, I will give him a yogurt. We do the Stonyfield brand. If I don't have any pouches, typically I'll have a little bit of yogurt in the fridge, so I'll just make up my own version of yogurt for him. But these come in handy, especially for snack time, so I can just hand it to him. So that's usually most that he'll get for like snack time. Like I said, sometimes he'll share like a bagel with me or something. He'll have a few bites, or he'll get other fruits. But he had a lot of fruit with breakfast this morning, so I don't want to give him too much of that at once, because it gets boring. So that's what we're doing for snack time. So for lunches, I just decided to do this salad, and with the salad, I like to add tomatoes and a little bit of cheese to it. It's all just a prepackaged thing, so it's an easy thing for me to do on a weekday when I'm trying to get lunch out quick. But this is pretty much just what I do. I add my own little stuff to it, so that way it's not just the packaged salad. And for this day, for Avery's lunch, I just gave him his leftover ravioli that he had from the day before. He only eats about a half a can at a time, if that. So this is pretty much just what I do. I heat it up in the microwave, and then I cut it into smaller portions for him, because these pieces, even though they're mini ravioli, are still too big for him. He didn't eat all of it, but that's okay, because he ate almost all of it. All right, it's about 3:15. Usually it's about 3:30 when I give him a snack, but he had lunch early today. So I gave him one of these pouches. So these pouches are like the brand Happy Baby. It's got bananas, raspberries, and oats in it, so it'll probably hold him over till dinner. If he still seems hungry after having the pouch, then I will offer him some fruits. I got grapes and bananas and stuff like that, something that's other than blueberries and strawberries. And if for some reason that doesn't hold him over, then I'll probably just give him another kind of like half a bar that I had from this morning. You need help with that? So this, he just brought me this. This is what he has eaten so far. He He brings it to me so that way I can help him squeeze. You wanna stand up? So I can help him squeeze it from the bottom because he doesn't quite understand it, so he'll bring it to me when it gets stuck on the bottom. There you go. He's really good about it though, aside from that. So yeah, these little pouches do well for afternoon snacks to hold over until dinner. Like I said, if that doesn't satisfy him, then I will usually give him some fruits as well. Or a half of like one of those little bars that I showed you earlier. You need help? You wanna come say hi? Say hi to the camera. Hi. Yeah, that's the same one you just had, baby. You can hold it, but you can't have it because you just ate the whole one. You just ate the whole one right there. Yeah, right there. Same thing. Same thing. So clearly, as you can see, he looks like he's still hungry. So I'll probably get him some grapes. I will show you how I cut them up just because I make them quite small. Got some grapes too? Yeah, probably. Alright, let me have that. You want any more of this? So these grapes aren't as big as the last package I got, so I probably won't cut them up as small as I did with the other ones, but I'll show you anyway. So with these ones, I just cut them into fourths and then in half. So like, I cut that in half, so that's a half a grape. And then I cut that in half again, and then the short way one more time. So then it comes out to these little fourths, basically. For dinner this night, we had leftovers, and the previous night we had a pork tenderloin, and I made this super simple like summer pasta salad. So it had like the tri-colored noodles, it had some cucumbers, some broccoli, some cheese, and some tomatoes all mixed together with ranch. And so you can see here I gave him a little portion of that, and then I'm just cutting up some pork tenderloin as well. So that is what we eat in a day. Thank you for sticking around. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, like and comment your favorite meals so we can try new stuff. See you guys next week. For this recipe, you're gonna need a pound of ground chicken and or ground turkey, a zucchini, a sweet potato, a couple eggs, some seasoning of your choice, that's what I chose, a mixing bowl, a grater, a peeler, a cutting board. So here I'm just taking the ground chicken and I'm adding it to the bowl. Next, you're gonna wanna grate your zucchini. I usually do about half, but I think half was a little bit more than what I needed for this. So I'd say maybe a fourth to a half, depending on how much chicken you're using. I used a pound in this, so I'm going based off of that.
you're done grating your zucchini and adding it to the chicken, you're gonna want to chop off the end of your sweet potato and peel it about halfway. I find that it's easier this way, so then you can grip the bottom half with the peel still on it. So I just do about half of it, and then I grate about the same amount of sweet potato as I did zucchini. And in this, I like to have a little bit of extra personally, so you'll see me add a little bit more than half. At this point, you're going to want to add 2 eggs to the mixture. This is kind of what helps it stay together as like a whole chicken patty. And after you're done with the eggs, I will add my seasoning. Seasoning is a personal preference thing. You can add different types of seasoning if you want. I also didn't put it in here, but I did add pepper to this, just a little bit, for a little bit of kick. I know that Avery likes that sometimes. So you just get all of your seasonings in there. You can personally add whatever kind of seasonings that you like. I do garlic and onion powder. At this point, I just use a fork. You can use your hands if you want, but I prefer using a fork to kind of just get everything mixed together pretty well, get it all well combined, make sure that everything is fairly even throughout the mixture. That's kind of why I use the fork, to make sure everything gets spread out. And this is what it looks like once it's evenly combined. For this, I actually used parchment paper, and I feel like I had the wrong kind of paper here. I think I was supposed to use wax paper. I honestly cannot remember. But you can also just use cooking spray on the pan if you would like. You're also going to want to preheat your oven to 450 at this point, so that way once you're done forming your patties, it is ready to go. I like to use an ice cream scoop so I can get more level patties. I don't really know how to explain it, but I don't really fill it all the way. I kind of fill it halfway and then scoop it out so that way I can flatten them on the sheet. Once I get all of my even scoops onto the tray, I use a fork to kind of form it into a patty. And at this point, this is how I know if one has more than the other, and I'll tend to scoop it out if I need to and kind of just put it back in the mixture to make some more, as you can see I did with that one. But after that, you're just going to throw it in the oven at 450 degrees for about 12 minutes. I would check it at about 10 minutes just to be safe. And always, always, always check your temperature when you are done. Make sure it hits 165 or higher. As you can see, they look a little funny on the parchment paper, and that's why I said I'm not sure if I had the right paper. I can't remember. Anyway, they came out delicious anyway, and they're super easy to store. How I store them is I put them in a Ziploc bag marked with the date, and they're usually good in the freezer up for 6 months, just about, or at least that's how long I have let them stay in there. They don't usually last that long in my household anyway, but they're super easy. You just take one out of the freezer when they're frozen, stick it in the microwave for a minute, chop them up to your liking for your child, and there you go. Super easy baby-led weaning recipe, good for 6 months and up.